press conference, President Trump said with defiance that he is 100% willing to testify under oath. The magnitude of that statement was not lost on the media.
He is 100% willing to speak under oath.
Well, you can really take that to the bank.
100%
under oath,
under oath,
under oath.
If you were his attorney, would you advise him to do this?
Absolutely not.
Under oath. Let's talk about it. I have a guest who knows how the mind of Trump works because he wrote a book about Trump. He's also seen how the now president behaves under oath because Trump sued him for defamation back in 2007. The testimony Trump gave back then, it was really notable because the lawyers in the case counted 30 times when the now president either misspoke or exaggerated things. Here's how the Washington Post described it recently. Quote, for two straight days, they asked Trump question after question that touched on some of the same theme, Trump's honesty. 30 times, they caught him. Tim O'Brien is the executive editor at Bloomberg View, and the book he authored is called TrumpNation, The Art of Being Donald, and he joins me now here in New York. Tim, you were a long time ago my editor at the New York Times on a few stories. At that time, you were dealing with this lawsuit, this defamation case. You prevailed in the case, but what did you learn when the now president was under oath?
Well, that his loose association or relationship with the truth becomes problematic for him when he's confronted with documents that are contrary to things that he said over the year publicly on a wide range of issues. In our deposition, it turned out he had misrepresented how much money he got for speaking fees. How briskly his condos were selling, how much money he had borrowed from the family estate when he almost went personally bankrupt, and on and on and on, issue after issue. And I was fortunate to have a great legal team that simply let him walk into that trap. He had said X publicly, and then we presented him with documents that were contrary to that.
Let's look at an example, something from these depositions. We can put on screen. It starts with saying, have you ever not been truthful? Trump says, my net worth fluctuates, and it goes up and down with markets and with attitudes and with feelings, even my own feelings, but I try to be truthful. And then it goes on to say, the lawyer says, let me just understand that a little bit. Let's talk about net worth for a second. You said that the net worth goes up and down based on your own feelings? Trump says, yes, even my own feelings as to where the world is going, and that can change rapidly from day to day. Tim, this was considered to be one of the most revealing parts of the deposition because the president's saying it's his feelings that are guiding what he's saying.
As opposed to reality, the numbers,
accounting,
the facts, accounting. In another part of the deposition, we asked him how he figured out how much his golf courses were worth. And he said he had no written documents that supported the valuations he placed on them. And my lawyer said, well, then how did you get to the numbers you got to? And he said, mental projections, which is another one of these phrases he uses. Back famously when The Art of the Deal first came out, he spoke about truthful hyperbole, his willingness to exaggerate about almost anything that came into his realm, people he had met, how much money he had, how successful he was. And he's never, we had decades now of Trump frequently lying or exaggerating about a wide range of things.
Now, I might say it's just bluster. Why does bluster matter, especially now that he's president, the idea of being under oath as president?
Well, I think there's a difference of bluster and exaggeration than flat-out lying. You know, okay. He said during the campaign that he had opposed the Iraq invasion. That wasn't true. He had said during the campaign he had only borrowed $1 million from his father. That wasn't true. But you now have him in the White House. He's overseeing national security. He's overseeing serious policy issues like health care and the tax structure. And if he can't be straight with the American people about just bare-bone, verifiable facts, we're in a very difficult place. And he's unusual in that regard.
Considering what happened when you had him under oath, do you think he actually will speak under oath to Robert Mueller?
I have to imagine every lawyer in the White House's eyes rolled back in their skull the minute he said, I'll be willing to testify under oath to Mueller. Mm-hmm. Because I think they don't understand the parameters of what they're up against here. Mueller could be at this for years. I think what you saw in the last week with Mike Rogers and Dan Coats and then Jim Comey testifying is they're clearing the decks. They're now getting out of the way for Mueller to have this investigation in a full-bore way. Mm. And he's going to subpoena people. He has access to global financial records. And he has an intelligence and a law enforcement community that is deeply disturbed, I think, by the president's behavior, and that's all going to come to bear on the president.
Last hour, Fareed Zakaria was expressing concern about what happens down the road if Mueller reaches some conclusions and the president rejects those conclusions. Could we see a repeat of what we saw before Election Day with the now president, then campaigner, saying essentially wasn't sure if he would accept the election results? Could we be in a similar position now with this investigation?
If there are criminal charges, those aren't voluntary issues. He can't simply ignore a criminal charge because he doesn't agree with it. So that's he's in a very different realm right now. I think he's played ping pong over the years, but this is the Super Bowl.
Last question for you. You mentioned that at one point, Trump, when he was suing you, suggested he had tapes of your conversations. What was that about, and did he have tapes?
Yeah, he said throughout, and he said this to reporters over the years when they've gone into the Trump organization is, okay, I just want to let you know I'm taping you right now. And he said it multiple times during my interviews with him. He said that into my own tape recorder when I recorded our interviews. But when he sat down for the deposition, my attorney said, Mr. Trump, do you have a taping system? And he said, no. And he said, well, then why did you say this to Mr. O'Brien? And he essentially said, I wanted to intimidate him.
That's the perfect segue for my next segment. Tim, great to see you.
Thank you, Brian.
Thank you for being here.
Good to be here.
Up next, why does secrecy seem to be the